Hello, a very warm welcome. Kerala University of Digital Sciences has invited application for various PhD programs for the year 2021. This Digital University of Kerala is one of its kind and is the first digital university in Kerala, or I would rather say first digital university in India. They offer postgraduate programs and research programs in various fields of digital technology. It's a rather new university established in the year 2020. It is formed with a vision of creating a futuristic institution of higher learning, aspiring to set a global benchmark in digital technology. The programs are tailored, taking into account the needs of industry and aims to address real-world problems of today and future. If you have a passion and curiosity to unravel the mysteries of the changing digital world, do join this digital university. So, how to join? Visit the website duk.ac.in/doctoral programs and you will see a web page similar to this. You will get all the relevant informations regarding doctoral program offered by the university in the quick links provided in the right hand side. On the right hand side, you can find quick links for all the details regarding PhD programs, like what is the program duration, how many years they will allow you to complete your research areas and school themes, different research areas and different schools, variety of topics they have given. So you can select the topic as per your eligibility and as per your aptitude. Program types, that is whether you intend to do your research as a full-timer or a part-timer, whatever it is, and admission requirements along with scholarships and fees. They have given all the details of whatever scholarships they will be providing and of course the fee structure. Then the Digital University Research Aptitude Test, or DRAT. They have even displayed the DRAT syllabus, that is according to which syllabus they will be conducting this aptitude test. For any further queries, you can contact admission phd@duk.ac.in. And in the right side, you can see a blue button, apply now. If you click that button, you will be going straight to your applying process. But before that, before applying, it's better you go through all the relevant information regarding PhD program. We will have a quick look through all these quick links. Like, what is the program duration? Program duration for full-timers, they are indicating you can take 36 months minimum to complete your research, up to a maximum of 72 months, that is a minimum of 3 years up to 6 years. For part-timers, a minimum of 48 months, that is 4 years, to a maximum of 6 years. That is, the maximum amount of time you can take is 6 years for both full-timers and part-timers. But for full-timers, they can submit their thesis as soon as they complete 3 years. They have also mentioned the qualifying degrees required for different faculty. Like for engineering, M.Tech is needed. For science, social science, technology, etc., MSc, MCA or M.Tech. And for science, social science, MA, MCOM, MBA. Important dates also they have mentioned. They have given the important dates as well. The last date for submitting your application is 30th of May 2021. And they are conducting a test, DRAT admission test, that is they are planning it to conduct on 20th of June 2021. And the PhD admission interview, they will be holding it between July 5th and July 10th of 2021. The date of commencement of PhD program is August 1, 2021. These dates, tentative dates they have given. Hope everything goes according to their chart. The research areas and school themes are also displayed. School of Computer Science and Engineering, they have given the indicative areas as well. You better go through the indicative areas. You see whether it is of your interest. And the vacancy position 17 for School of computer science and engineering. For School of Electronic System and Automation, vacancy is 9. There also they have given the indicative areas. Go through it. The School of Digital Humanities and Cultural Arts, no vacancies at present. School of Digital Science, vacancy list is 3. And School of Informatics, vacancy list is 1. Then moving on to the program types, you have 3 different types of programs. That is, you have the regular PhD. Entry requirement for that is MSc or MCA or MTech or MBA. And then you have the industry regular PhD, where the applicant is required to have at least 5 years of relevant full-time work experience after graduation at an officer or executive level. That is a different thing. That is industry regular PhD. You have to have 5 years of relevant full-time work experience. And then you have this part-time PhD. This is a part-time program where the candidate is expected to work with the faculty member remotely while in a full-time employment. So this is for employed people, part-time research. That is, the candidate is expected to work with the faculty member remotely while he or she himself is engaged in a full-time employment. Apart from that, for part-time research, the applicant is required to have at least 5 years of relevant full-time work experience after post-graduation at an officer or executive or teaching or industry level. That is, for applying for part-time research, many conditions they have given. At least 5 years of relevant full-time work experience after your post-graduation is necessary. So that is a requirement for those who wish to do part-time research. UGC norms on reservations for SC/ST seats will be followed. That's what they are saying. Applicants are shortlisted based on the DRAT exam score or GATE exam score. For DRAT exam, 60 percentile is needed, and for GATE, 80 percentile. Net JRF qualified candidates are exempted from DRAT exam. That is, they are exempted from the aptitude test this university is conducting. OBC, SC, ST candidates are given appropriate relaxations in cutoff. As usual, they are given relaxation. And for regular PhD, composite score of 80% for DRAT or equal and 20% for educational qualification is used for shortlisting the applicants. So how they are planning to shortlist? DRAT exam they will be conducting, and for regular PhD candidates, 80% score will be taken from that DRAT or equivalent. That is, if you are net JRF qualified, whatever it is, 80% score from that, and 20% for educational qualification. That is your MCA, MTech, whatever it is used for shortlisting the applicants. Anyway, final selection will be done through an interview. For part-timers shortlisting the candidates, they have put a different equation. Composite score of 30% for work experience, 20% for DRAT, 20% for statement of purpose, 10% for recommendation letter, 20% for educational qualification. This is the equation they have given. Composite score of 30% for work experience, that is 30% score for work experience they will be giving. Work experience, they have asked you need minimum 5 years of work experience. Work experience, they have requirement is at least 5 years of relevant full-time experience. That is, those who have 5 years of relevant, maybe 30% is given, or I don't know whether less than 5 years they will be considering. You can ask your queries in the phone number given. And then 20% marks from DRAT they will be taking for part-timers. And 20% for statement of purpose. I don't know what is the statement of purpose. That is, why you are doing research. For that, depending on your research proposal, maybe 20% is given. And 10% for recommendation letter. That also is not clear for me as such. Who will be recommending, whose recommendation letter is necessary. 20% for educational qualification is used for shortlisting the part-timers. Apart from that, they will be having interview also. For the admission to the regular PhD program, applicants who have already been awarded scholarships like UGC, JRF, CSIR, JRF, DBT, JRF or other national or international scholarships, they will be given preference. For the admission, these people having so and so scholarships will be given preference. That is what they are saying. And moving on to the scholarship and fees, regular PhD, first year, 20,000 per month. Scholarships they are providing. This is university scholarship. Second year, 25% per month they are providing. And third year, 30,000 per month. This is the scholarship structure. And fees for regular PhD, first to fifth year, no tuition fees. Sixth year, 50% fee concession. I don't know 50% of what. It's not clear. Anyway, they are giving 50% fee concession. That is for the first 1 to 5 years, no tuition fees. You can complete your research as soon as you complete your third year. And up to 5 years, no tuition fees is there. So up to third year, within 3 years you complete, that is the best thing. And if you cross that sixth year, 50% fee concession, that is 50% you have to pay. Seventh year onwards, re-registration you have to do with full fee that is required. So it will be very dangerous if you cross the seventh year. Seventh year onwards, re-registration with full fee. Depends on certain topics you take. Sometimes it will be prolonged due to many reasons, but it's always well and good if you finish it within 5 years. Industry regular PhD, no scholarships they are providing. Apart from that, 50,000 rupees fees you have to pay annually. And for part-time PhD, no scholarship provided, 50,000 fees per year you have to pay. The above scholarship is provided for those who do not have any other external fellowships such as GRF or GATE or project assistantships. Okay, this scholarship is provided for those who don't have any other scholarships. Now moving on to the aptitude test, DRAT. Twice in a year, online applications are invited for DRAT. That is, 2 times in a year they will be calling. Validity of DRAT is for 2 years. That's also a good thing. Once you go through the exam, the aptitude test, it is valid for 2 years. So even if this year your subject doesn't have a vacancy, you can apply for PhD registration next year. If you have passed, if you have gone through the DRAT exam this year, so it is valid for 2 years. DRAT exam will consist of 30 questions from English, 30 questions from Maths, and 40 from the specific concerned subject. They have even provided DRAT syllabus, that is, you can have a detailed look what all syllabus they have given for the aptitude test. Now, having gone through all the quick links, having now you have got all the required information about the PhD program, about the duration, the scholarship, the fees, everything, the different types of PhD programs. Now you are well aware of the vacancy position also. And if your concerned subject, your area of research has got vacancy, you can very well apply. While applying, you have to click this blue button. And 8 simple steps you have to create an account. Primary info you have to after giving your primary info, your personal info, your academics and certification, experience and publication details, school and area of interest, professional references, documents you have to upload, and confirmation and preview application form. After doing all these 8 steps, you will be completing your online application for PhD program in the first digital university in India. That is, the campus is in Kerala, Thiruvananthapuram.